Hello, my name is Cy, Cy Gunn. Do you want to go to the Iowa State football game this weekend? I go to the homecoming game each year ever since I learned the traditions. My mama always said, life is like an Iowa State football game. You never know what's gonna happen. I love Destination Iowa State, but I've always loved homecoming more.
Why is that?
Homecoming is one of the highlights of Iowa State, featuring our most cherished traditions. I bet if I think about it real hard, I can remember my first homecoming football game and how I discovered what it was all about. Now, I don't recall what I wore that day, but there was one thing I won't forget. The students gushing with Iowa State spirit.
You can sit here if you want.
So I sat next to her, and she asked me about homecoming.
I see that you're playing in the big game this weekend. Do you know about homecoming and all the traditions?
Mama said homecoming is like a magical show, but I ain't ever heard about no traditions.
Are you crazy? How do you not know about Iowa State's homecoming traditions? You're literally playing in the game. How do you expect to win if you don't know what homecoming is all about? Well, that's okay. You still have time to learn. I'm Winnie Winderstein, by the way.
I'm Cy Gunn. Can you teach me about the traditions of homecoming before the game Saturday?
Well, I have a Lib 160 exam to study for. I heard it is the most failed class at Iowa State. Do you know anyone that can help you out?
Mama said that she has a friend that played at Iowa State. She said he's at some place called, Ocean Laverne? Maybe I'll take a dive at that.
Hey, Cyclone, you really think you can beat us Saturday?
Yeah, we're gonna crush you and any homecoming spirit you have.
Wait, I don't think he even knows what homecoming is about.
Without homecoming spirit, there's no way you can win.
I'll learn those traditions and find out what makes our state homecoming so special. And we'll win that homecoming game for sure.
He's trying to get away. Get him.
Run, Cy, run. Run around the world if you have to. You have to find the meaning of homecoming before the game.
I ran around the world searching for Ocean Laverne and Mama's friend, Luke Tennant Dan. He was an Iowa State football player during the homecoming game against the Jayhawks way back in 2015. He showed so much ISU spirit that day that he became known as Lieutenant Dan. When I finally made it to Ocean Laverne and saw a massive fishing boat atop the water, I knew it was him, so I swam on over there.
Lieutenant Dan, I found you.
Cy? Hey, Cy, how's your mama doing? Is she still watching all the Iowa State football games?
She is. That's why she named me after the Iowa State mascot.
I can't blame her. I love Cy. He's the greatest mascot in all the sports. He had so much homecoming spirit, I even named my boat after him.
I see that. This is quite the boat. Hey, so, speaking of homecoming spirit, I kind of have a problem.
What is it?
I have a big homecoming game on Saturday against the Red Raiders. But I don't know any homecoming traditions.
Well, you're in luck, Mr. Sager. I sleep and breathe homecoming spirit. I even bleed red and gold. Every year, I make it back to Iowa State for the big game. I can teach you every homecoming tradition you need to know to win that football game.
Really? Where do we start?
Well, it's time to catch a memory or two from my homecoming days. Welcome aboard the SS Sager. Then we just started fishing and talking and fishing. I learned about food on campus, excitement in streets, Jack Trice, and even this thing called Curtis the Beer Share. Lieutenant Dan said that was his favorite.
Wow, I had no idea there were so many great traditions. I feel like I'm as smart as Professor Butler. Thanks, Lieutenant Dan.
No problem, Cy. That was a nice trip down memory lane.
I think I'm starting to understand what homecoming is all about, but I feel like there's more I can learn to prepare for the game on Saturday. Are there any more traditions I should know about?
Well, I got a perfect one for you, but you have to see it for yourself. How about you travel to D.C.? I heard that after we won that Jayhawk game, the president was so impressed that they replaced the Washington Monument with a campanile. That's where they could yell like hell, the most famous and craziest homecoming tradition.
Okay, I'll go check it out. Thank you for everything, Lieutenant Dan.
See you around the world, Si. Woohoo!
How is he so fast? He's getting away again. Keep growing.
Suckers. So I ran all the way to Washington, D.C. Mama always said that campanile was her favorite tradition in our state, but she wouldn't tell me what it means. She said I was too young to know. As I was running, all I could think about was Wendy. I didn't want to let her down.
What's this big stage for?
What are you doing? You're supposed to be bowling.
Bowling? I don't know how to bowl, but I know how to play ping pong.
You have to bowl for yell like hell. It's a little like ping pong. Pretend there are four ping pong balls coming at you at once.
Something like this?
You're getting there. How about you join everyone on stage and do it?
So do I do it now?
That's perfect. You have got this homecoming tradition down. You have to join us for our final performance. We'll paint you as the main character.
Wendy!
Nice job, Si. Did you finally learn what homecoming is all about?
Yes, I learned so much. I think I'm ready to win this football game.
Shoot, you're gonna be late. Hurry and get to Jack Trice.
Well, well, well. I see you finally discovered what homecoming is all about.
We're not worried knowing some silly traditions can't save you. We're gonna win that game.
Yes, it does. I'll prove you wrong. Now that I know what homecoming is all about, there's no way we can lose.
Not again.
That was a close game. It came down to the final seconds and we were down one score. It was up to me to return the kickoff for a touchdown and win the game.
To show how special homecoming truly is.
Proud of you, kid.
I'm really glad. I think you found your homecoming spirit, Si. Come on, let's celebrate.
We have the homecoming game tomorrow. I'm so excited to watch the Cyclones go 8-0. If Sai isn't back soon, we'll have to cancel the homecoming game. Who's gonna save Sai?
Ethan! Look over there! It's Zach!
Thanks for untying me. Those ropes were starting to hurt.
Zach, what happened to you? Are you okay?
Well, when I was walking back from class, I noticed the Red Raider sneak into the Campanile carrying the Zodiac. But when I went to investigate, I noticed that he was dragging Sai along with him.
So, what did you do?
Gave him the old 1-2, right?
Well, he knocked me out. When I woke up, I saw him get on Siren. I tried to chase after him, but he tied me to his dang Campanile.
Wait a minute. This isn't the Campanile.
What do you mean? Yes, it is.
Wait, this looks familiar. It's the lighthouse from Alexandria, one of the 7 wonders of the ancient world. Taylor, didn't we just learn about this in history class?
Whenever I'm in that class, I'm just thinking about how our basketball team will be making history.
How are you guys freaking out? If we don't find the Red Raider and stop him, the homecoming spirit will be gone forever!
So, what do we do?
Well, I guess it's up to us to figure this mess out.
Where do we start?
I don't know. The Red Raider was going on about the 7 wonders of the ancient world or something.
Look!
Where's Giza? Texas?
No, silly. Giza is in Egypt. As in, the pyramids of Giza?
Oh, can this count as my semester abroad?
Wait a minute. How on earth did Siren make its way to Giza?
Let's ask the bus driver.
Hey, bus driver, do you have any idea how the Red Raider managed to find its way to Giza?
No. I haven't seen him. I mean...
Then why does it say your bus went to Giza?
Okay, I'll admit it. The Red Raider told me he'd make me walk across the Zodiac if I didn't take him there. With midterms around the corner, I can't afford to fail another exam.
Well, you better hope that we can fix this before it's too late. Otherwise, midterms will be the last of your worries.
How did you get the Raider to Egypt anyways?
Well, we flew, of course.
Flew?
You didn't know Sairad can fly? You guys really need to start paying attention during Destination Iowa State.
Guys, as crazy as this is, we really should get going to Giza now. Bus driver, we need to get to Egypt.
Next stop, Giza. You guys be quick. I've got places to be.
Why in the world would the Red Raider want to come to Egypt? These deserts are so hot and muggy.
He probably misses the scorching heat and boring landscape. It must remind him of Texas.
Ignore the heat. These pyramids are incredible.
Yeah, and they're just about as dusty as Texas Tech's trophy cabinet.
Hey, don't you dare disrespect my school.
Red Raider?
Get him!
Nanny, see you suckers in Greece. You can never catch me. Bus driver?
Great going, everyone. Our ride left us stranded.
Guys, look on the bright side. At least we found the Zodiac.
I'll get it.
The bus is back.
I came back as soon as I could. You guys helped me recognize the importance of homecoming spirit. Without it, the Cyclones would never succeed.
We don't know what we would have done if you hadn't come back. Can you take us to the Raider?
Sure. I have some extra time before I need to make my next stop at Park's Library. Greece, here we come.
Were made.
But no just pizza?
Hey, quit messing around. You need to look for Sai.
Thank goodness you guys are here. I'm the Colossus of Rhodes, almighty protector of Rhodes City.
The Colossus of Rhodes! I can't believe I'm face to face with another wonder of the ancient world.
Colossus, we need your help finding the Red Raider.
The Red Raider, you say? I saw him this morning. As I was guarding my post, he sailed in on the boat. With him, he carried a majestic red bird and a bell tower that rivals even the most magnificent architecture here in Greece. This raider has been wreaking havoc all day.
That sounds like Sai and the Camp Neil. Do you know where we might be able to find them?
Why, yes, but that's just the problem. The Red Raider awoke Zeus from his throne, but replaced him with Sai. Sai's been frozen in place all day, and Zeus won't stop complaining to me about it. I can't stand that whimpering fool.
He must mean the statue of Zeus at Olympia, another wonder of the ancient world.
Can you show us the way?
Why, certainly. Anything to stop Zeus from grumbling.
Thank you, Colossus. Lead the way.
You will find your elegant bird in an extravagant bell tower south of the Temple of Artemis, and just west of the mausoleum at Halicarnassus.
That's why the Lighthouse of Alexandria is back at campus. The Red Raider must have switched to when I was knocked out.
I missed the Campanile. Campus just isn't the same without this thing.
Zeus! He's so much taller in person.
Yeah, he is.
Thank goodness you guys are here. Sai's been sleeping in my chair all day, and I haven't had a second to rest my feet. You need to rest? Looks like the Almighty Zeus isn't so mighty after all.
What did you say?
I don't know. For someone who is hailed as the father of gods, you sure seem to complain a lot.
How dare you disrespect me, peasants? You can't even begin to fathom my strength, you mean sprout.
All right, that's enough. We need to remember why we're here.
He's right. Sai isn't waking up, and the Campanile isn't where it belongs.
I will make you a deal. I will help you replace your Campanile, but you must get that bird out of my chair.
Deal.
What do we do? He won't wake up.
There's got to be something that will wake him up.
Maybe a chant, or a dance, or...
Sai, are you okay?
I am now. I was worried I would be here for a while. It's a good thing you guys came to rescue me. My team needs me.
I missed you.
As good as it is to be back, there are some things I need to attend to. Just after that infuriating Red Raider awoke Zeus from his chair, he hid to avoid Zeus's wrath. I know he's still nearby. Everybody spread out.
Put me down. I'll sue.
Looks like we have our Raider.
I should banish you for eternity for what you have done.
I have a better idea. The Raiders seem to love to visit the legendary Seven Wonders of the Ancient World, but there was one place he hasn't been, the Hanging Gardens of Babylon.
Bus driver, got room for one more?
Where are we headed?
To the Gardens of Babylon!
I am forever indebted to you. To show my thanks, I'll use my thunder to transport your Campanile and all you guys back to Hades. Goodbye, mortals. Good luck on your journey.
Thanks, Zeus! Thanks, guys. You all have restored the homecoming spirit, and now the homecoming game can begin.
Anything for you, Sai.
Job's not finished. Come on, gang. We need to get there ASAP.
Texas Tech has nothing on us.
Come on, y'all. Let's get to the game.
This is a cyclone weather alert. Ladies and gentlemen, radar has indicated a strong storm approaching Jack Rice Stadium. High winds and low visibility are expected.
Toto, I don't think we're in Kansas anymore. We must be somewhere over the rainbow. Arf, arf! Oh, hello there. I'm Glinda, the Good Witch of the Big 12. Who are you?
I'm Dorothy Gale from Kansas. I'm a freshman at Iowa State University, and I can't quite seem to find campus.
Well, you're in luck. Welcome to Iowa State University. Seems like you've already defeated one of our biggest rivals.
Not all of them! How dare you kill my sister, the Iowa Hawkeyes!
I didn't mean to. It was an accident.
Where are the Cardinal slippers? Give me those. I need them to win the big homecoming game.
Remember, Texas Tech, you have no power here on ISU's campus. Now leave this freshman alone.
I'll get you, my pretty, and your little dog, too.
Now that you have those slippers, you must be careful. They hold the school spirit to win the homecoming football game. Bring them to Jack Trice Stadium to the Wizard of Oz to make sure that they are in safe hands.
How do I get to Oz?
You must follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road? Oh no, where do I go?
You can go that way, or I suppose you can go that way. Oh, who am I kidding? I haven't got a brain to tell you.
Haven't got a brain?
I haven't got a brain, only straw. I'll never pass my Library 160 exam next week.
Maybe the wizard could help you. You should come with me.
The wizard? Let's go.
Who is this?
Oil can.
I'm not sure. What is he saying?
Oil can.
I don't know.
Oil can.
Oh, he needs the oil can.
Thank you so much for helping me. I've been stuck since it rained last year. Oh no, that must mean it's about time for Iowa State's homecoming.
Well, yes, that's true.
Has Camp Annealing happened yet?
What's that?
Traditionally, Iowa State students gather on Central Campus by the campanile on homecoming night and kiss their special someone when the clock strikes midnight to become a true Iowa Stater.
Oh, that sounds wonderful.
It would be, but I haven't got a heart, so I can't.
Come with us. We're going to see the wizard. If he can give me brains, I'm sure he can give you a heart.
I would love to.
What's that?
Well, you know the haunted forest is filled with lions and tigers and bears.
Why are you screaming?
I'm scared.
Are you a student at Iowa State too?
Barely. I haven't got the courage to participate in homecoming events going on this week. I haven't got any courage at all.
Oh, well, that's not good. You should come with us to meet the wizard. I bet he's got some courage to give you.
Yippee!
Hello? We are looking for the wizard. We need to see him.
Who are you? Who are you?
Hello, we are new students at Iowa State and we have come to ask for help.
I need a brain to do well in school.
I need a heart to go campanealing.
I need courage to be a part of homecoming activities.
And what about you, Dorothy?
I have come to return the Cardinal slippers to you to ensure Iowa State's victory against Texas Tech during the homecoming game.
Not if I have anything to do with it. Give me those slippers.
Quick, we need to think. Oh, wait, I have a plan.
Come here, Dorothy. I'll take care of you.
All right, Lion. I need you to toss this on the Wicked Witch.
Okay.
I'm melting! Melting! We will never win the homecoming game now! Oh! Oh!
We did it!
Arf, arf.
I knew you could do it all along. Scarecrow, you had the brains to create the plan. Tin Man, you had the heart to protect your friend Dorothy. And Lion, you had the courage to defeat the Wicked Witch. You all embody the perfect homecoming school spirit.
Yay!
Dorothy, I knew I could count on you. Now, in order to win this homecoming game, close your eyes. Tap your heels together 3 times while repeating, "There's no place like Ames."
There's no place like Ames. There's no place like Ames.
there's no place like Ames.
We just won the homecoming game!
Woo! Goodbye, Dorothy. See you after Thanksgiving.
Welcome back to the Wheel of Fortune, where tonight's puzzle is all about travel. You could say we're cyclones spinning. Get it? Cyclones spinning? And now let's bring out the lovely Vanna Winterstein to introduce tonight's fabulous prizes.
Thanks, Pat. Our lucky winner today could be packing their bags for an incredible study abroad adventure in Florence, Italy. It's a prize that's sure to be bellissimo.
Thank you, Vanna. Now let's meet our contestants. First up, we have Blake Laverne, a senior in mechanical engineering. Blake, how's that workload treating you?
Let's just say my textbooks weigh more than my car, Pat.
I feel you, Blake. Good luck tonight. Next up, we've got Lydia Larch, a marketing major and cheerleader. And last but not least, we have Jimmy Jardine, a business major. Jimmy, future CEO, right?
That's the plan, Pat. First, I need to survive another group project.
Ah, the classic business experience. All right, Blake, you're up first.
I'll take an R, Pat.
One R. Not bad. You're off to a solid start, like your GPA, I hope.
It's holding steady, I promise.
Good. Lydia, you're up. Give it a spin.
How about an S?
Nope. No S's.
Jimmy, let's see what you've got.
Is there a T?
One T?
Feels like you just closed a deal, huh? Blake, back to you.
Let's go with an N.
One N. Lydia, back to you. What's your play?
Let's go with an L.
One L. Looks like you're spelling it out. Kind of like a college student's favorite way to spell success.
C-R-A-M. Cram.
Let's give it up for her enthusiasm. Jimmy, your move.
Can I get a C?
One C. You're closing in on this puzzle faster than someone grabbing a front row seat for Visha. Blake, what do you think? Spin or solve?
I'll solve it, Pat. Sigh around the world.
Yes, sigh around the world. Blake, you've solved it. And that wraps up this round. Stay tuned for more action on Game Show Cywork. Go Cyclone.
Good evening, Iowa State. This is Taylor coming to you live from the Cyclone Weather Alert Desk with some headlines that are more twisted than your roommate's questionable taste in partners. Take it away, Sam.
It's homecoming week at Iowa State, which means traditions like getting covered in house paint, digging holes for lawn display, and a 5K that, quote, looks more like a Sunday morning walk of shame.
Regardless, homecoming at Iowa State is all about winning and traditions. In contrast, the University of Iowa's homecoming this year brought home a mediocre defeat to Michigan State and left fans with questions like, wait, it was homecoming?
In other news, reports have emerged that Cy is considering a new workout plan after a recent selfie revealed he might be getting a bit fluffy. Sources say he started the year strong until he walked past a tailgate with some fantastic barbecue and, well, he didn't make it to the game.
Well, then don't tell Cy. We've received exclusive reports. There's a way to promote excitement towards their meals. Season's Dining Hall will begin hosting Mystery Meat Mondays. If you ask me, they've been doing this for years.
And what's this? Iowa State has announced they'll be hosting a new event to study the effects of high winds on corn. You know what they say, it's all fun and games until someone loses an ear.
Last year, ISU Parking Division reported almost $5 million in fines. When questioned, the head of the parking division responded, "Listen here, you're paying for the building, but not the pleasure of reaching it. then gave the student a ticket for asking the question before 5:30 p.m.
I just hope they forget about the $2,000 in parking fines that I haven't paid yet. Well, that's all for now. I'm Sam.
And I'm Taylor. As we send you back to the game show action, from all of us here at the studio, thank you for tuning in to the Cyclone Weather Alert Desk.
Welcome to Family Feud. I'm your host, Cy Harvey, and tonight's stop on our Family Feud Around the World Tour brings us to the one and only Ames, Iowa. We've got the professors versus our students. All right, enough talk. Give me Bootsma, give me Greta, let's play Family Feud. All right, guys, here we go. We asked 100 Iowa State students and faculty, what is your go-to excuse for missing class?
Well, Cy, I'm going to go with being sick.
All right, Bootsma, good start. Let's keep it moving. Now, who do we got next?
Hi, Mr. Harvey. My name is Dr. Jody Sterley. I'm an animal science professor here at Iowa State.
Oh, animal science, huh? Now, I gotta ask, what's more work, teaching those animals or teaching them students?
Well, Steve, sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
Oh, I bet. Well, Doctor, what is your go-to excuse for missing class?
Well, Cy, there sure happen to be a lot of sick aunts and uncles around finals time. Let's go with family emergency.
Oh, yeah. It's always that mysterious family emergency. How many uncles you got? Am I right? Show me. Family emergency. Two out of two so far. Now, who do we have going for three in a row?
Hello, I'm Professor Butler, a.k.a. Beard Meets Calculus, on YouTube for those who know me.
Oh, baby. We've got a campus celebrity in our midst. Mr. Butler, what is your go-to excuse for missing class?
Superstition is strong here at Iowa State, and I've even heard some students run home after stepping on the Zodiac.
You see, I haven't worried about a test since the 70s, so you know what I like to do when I cross the Zodiac? Sit on it! It was worth a shot. And now we're here with the student team, with the fabulous Greta Gilman. Greta, I hear you're a bio major. What's the most interesting thing you've learned this semester?
Well, I learned that plants can actually communicate with each other.
Communicate? So you're saying when I forget to water my houseplants, they've been talking trash about me? I love it! So, Greta, if you miss class, what would your go-to excuse be?
I'm going with, I had a group project.
Boom! There it is! Now let's meet our next contestant, Peter Parks. Peter is a music major with dreams of hitting it big time in the music industry. Is that right, Peter?
Absolutely, Steve.
So, what's your go-to excuse for missing class, Peter?
I gotta go with the good old dead grandma.
Well, would you look at that? Next up is Bailey Buchanan, a dedicated history major. What would your go-to excuse be?
I'll go with getting chased by geese.
Not quite what we were looking for, but boy, those geese sure do love to make a scene. All right, it's the professor's turn now. Next up, we have Professor Michael Bootsma. What's your go-to excuse for missing class?
Well, Steve, sometimes you just find yourself in a bit of a splashy situation. I'll say, I fell into the MU fountain.
Wow, that's quite the excuse. But unfortunately, it's not on the board. That's two strikes for the professors. Over to the students again. All right, Greta, what's your excuse for missing class?
I'll go with, the dog ate my homework.
Now that is a classic. Well done, Greta. All right, Peter Parks, it's your turn again. You have a chance to win it all here.
How about, stuck waiting in line at Panda Express?
Oh. That's two strikes for the students. Let's see if the professors can steal this one. All right, we're back with the professors. Jody Sterley, it's all on you. You guys have two strikes, but if you can get this right, you win the game.
I'm going to say, stuck behind a tractor.
I mean, I know it's Iowa, but there's no way it happens that often, right? Let's see if it's up there. I can't believe it! Congratulations! You and the professors have won this round. What an exciting game we had today. The professors took home the victory this time, but the students definitely gave them a run for their money. Thank you for tuning in to Family Feud. Have a great night, and we'll catch you next time on Game Show Sci-World.